Industry producers need to become carbon neutral by 2050. This is a challenge in particular for energy-intensive production processes like the steel industry. Their production lines require a large amount of energy and heat, with global consequences on our climate. There are other energy-intensive industries, such as aluminium production or the manufacturing of ceramic tiles, that have a similar impact on the world's climate. For 4 years, an international team of engineers have worked together in the European innovation project ETEKINA to lower CO2 emissions by more than 40% in 3 different industrial processes. For this, they are adapting a 50-year-old thermal transfer principle called heat pipes. A heat pipe is a long metal tube that transfers thermal energy passively from a hot to a cold stream. Such a sealed pipe is filled with a volatile liquid. After the fluid has absorbed heat energy at the lower end, it vaporizes and carries the thermal energy upwards to the condenser section, where it encounters a lower temperature. As this section is cooler, the vapor turns back to a liquid and thereby releases heat energy. The liquid runs down the inner wall back to the evaporator section, where it all starts over again. In a heat pipe heat exchanger, many of those heat pipes are assembled in a line. Depending on the design of these alignments and the design of the individual heat pipes, engineers find the most effective heat transfer for the different industrial settings. The ETEKINA project has identified 3 demo sites where such a type of heat exchanger was designed for, constructed, installed, and its performance monitored. One prototype of a heat pipe heat exchanger was installed at an aluminium alloy production plant of Fagor Edelan in the Basque Country. The heat exchanger unit recovers waste heat from the furnace and channels it to an aging furnace where the aluminium parts are treated to improve some of their mechanical features. Because of space limitations within the production line, the heat exchanger unit was installed on top of one of its main furnaces. Ecolan, a regional research and technology center, who also acted as the coordinator of the project, is verifying the performance of this unit.
Llevamos como 3 semanas en los que estamos monitorizando datos y bueno, a falta de un análisis más detallado de estos datos, sí que hemos visto que en los quemadores de la primera zona del horno hay una reducción de casi un 50% en el consumo de los quemadores. Entonces, bueno, son unos resultados muy optimistas que tenemos que seguir haciendo el control hasta el final del proyecto.
Also, the installation costs and recovery rates are very attractive. The return of investment has been calculated to 24 months, which is also a reason why the Spanish owner of the foundry is expecting to install additional units for their other production lines.
Edelan tiene 17 plantas productivas en todo el mundo, de las cuales son hay 4 fundiciones de aluminio semejante a la fundición que hemos puesto en el intercambiador. Entonces, ¿nuestro objetivo cuál es? Pues replicarlo en esas nuevas líneas productivas.
Most of the steel producers are using electric-powered furnaces for melting and gas-powered furnaces for heat treatment, like here at SIJ Metal Ravne in Slovenia. Christian Plesnik is the energy manager, and he has helped to install the heat pipe heat exchanger prototype. It is located above one of their dozens of gas-powered furnaces and consists of 2 parts, an air-to-air section and an air-to-water section to maximize the possible heat recovery.
U okviru projekta smo izvedli nov zajem odpadnih plinov, ki jih s temperaturo okrog 450 stopinj vodimo v prvi toplotni izdelovalec za ogrevanje zgorevalnega zraka, ki ga nadaljne potrebujemo v sami peči. Celoten sistem nadziramo z loputami in pa dodatnimi tepali. Nadaljno vodimo dimne pline okrog temperature 220 stopinj Celzija preko toplotnega izmenjevalca za ogrevanje vode, ki jo nadaljne potrebujemo za naše ogrevanje samih prostorov. Dimni plini izmenjevalca zapuščajo s temperaturo okrog 150 stopinj Celzija in jih nato preko sesalnega ventilatorja odvajamo v zračje.
The unit recovers 350 kilowatts, which corresponds to an average reduction of 425 tons of carbon dioxide equivalent per year. The Josef Stefan Institute, based in Ljubljana, is monitoring this unit.
Sistem je v prvi rezultat delovanja sistema prikazal, da mi imamo več kot 50 do 60% izkoristek odvečne toplote, ki gre v zrak oziroma ki gre v nič. In s tem tudi znižamo emisije toplogrednih plinov v zrači. Take rezultati, ki nam dajo okrog več kot 350 kW moči na obe strani, vodni in zračni, bo tudi ekonomsko zelo učinkovit, posebno v tem času, ko imamo višji ceni energentov in višji ceni kuboni, CO2 kuboni.
The unit in the steel plant reduces their primary energy consumption of this single furnace by 47%. While the market value of such a unit is recovered in only 9 months by the savings in energy bills. Alois Buwald is the executive director of steel processing and sees the newly installed heat pipe heat exchanger only as a first step in modernizing his plant.
Yeah, we have a great potential. Zdaj trenutno ocenjujemo, da bomo s tem heat exchangerjem in tudi z ostalimi sistemi uporabljali približno 15% odpadne toplote. Metala imamo preko 70 ogrevnih peči, peči za toplotno obdelavo, ki v večji meri deluje na zemeljski plin. Tako da potencijala je dovolj.
To test the concept of recycling heat waste in the ceramics industry, a third heat pipe heat exchanger was installed at the production facilities of Atlas Concord near Modena in Italy. For the engineers, it was important that the unit would not interfere with the actual production process and keeping all piping and heat transfer processes outside the plant. The fully functional prototype recovers waste heat from the furnace at a temperature of around 245 degrees Celsius. This heat waste is used to power a pressurized water cycle from 115 to 155 degrees Celsius at the top of the unit. The hot water cycle is then used to heat the spray dryer at the beginning of the production process. The inventor of the ETEKINA heat pipe heat exchanger technology is Professor Hussam Johara from Brunel University, London.
The project, as you can see here, aims at extracting heat in a passive manner from an exhaust flow coming through this duct here from the process inside the factory. The exhaust goes through the heat pipe heat exchanger. Inside you have heat pipes staggered in a certain configuration to absorb the heat in a passive manner. The heat is then delivered to the shell, which heats then water flow to high temperature that goes to the factory to be used in various areas. The unit itself absorbs 700 kilowatts, that's about 0.7 megawatts of energy, and delivers this heat to the water, which then you directly used in the company, leading to two things: reduction in fuel used and enhancing its environmental status because it reduces the emissions.
Designing such a unit with exhaust flue gases is an engineering challenge. The exhaust streams straight from the kilns contain both fluoridic acid and particulate, and have high temperatures and flow rates that could possibly damage the system. So the engineers had to find the right setup and select the right materials for the heat pipes so that the thermal recovery will work efficiently inside the plant's environment and within the temperature range applied. The installation of the unit in Italy was supported by Professor Luca Montorsi from the University of Reggio Emilia and Modena.
Uno degli aspetti più difficili dell'unità per Atlas Concorde è stato il contenuto di particolato, di polveri presenti nei gas di scarico, quindi polveri che fluiscono all'interno dello scambiatore di calore e che possono attaccarsi alle superfici di scambio termico dello scambiatore di calore, provocando una riduzione delle prestazioni del sistema stesso.
The first monitoring data shows that the new heat pipe heat exchanger unit is able to recover thermal energy by more than 40%. This means the investment cost should be recovered within 24 months. Such devices could therefore help the ceramic industry in Europe to increase its competitiveness while reducing its environmental impact as well.
abbiamo stimato un determinato recupero termico ed è quello che troviamo con tutte le fluttuazioni che sono caratteristiche del processo, troviamo misurato e altrettanto troviamo il riscontro in termini di riduzione di consumo di gas naturale e di emissioni da parte dello spread dryer dell'utenza, che poi è il nostro goal, il nostro obiettivo. Noi vogliamo consumare meno gas naturale, vogliamo emettere meno CO2, vogliamo ridurre il nostro carbon footprint con ogni tipo di intervento di recupero possibile.
Hussam Juhara, his collaborators and other scientists work hard to achieve the COP21 goal for energy-intensive industries to become carbon neutral by 2050. It may still be a long way to go, but with a technology like heat pipe heat exchangers, it's already becoming a much more realistic vision.
The target for ETEKINA was 40% recovery of the available heat that is being wasted from the exhaust streams. I am pleased to say that after 4 years and having installed the 3 units, the consortium managed to get the 40% as the minimum. We are actually above that in all the 3 demo cases, and this is something, it's a pleasure to report.